Hi, and welcome back to Arno TV. I'm your lovable host, Arno, coming back to you with another video. Now, today's video, I'm going to tell you a little story about an anecdote that ended up in a book called Peaceville Life, which was written by Hammy, who was the guy that created the Peaceville record label back in 1987. And this anecdote, I'm in it. So basically, in this book, there's a little section in there where he's talking about that he'd never really witnessed rock and roll behaviour from any of the bands on the label, apart from the band that I was in, and goes into this little story about what I'm going to tell you about. So anyway, we were signed to Peaceville in 1995. I think it was the back end of 1995, November, if my memory serves me right. And shortly after we'd signed to Peaceville, the label itself got bought out by a larger label called Music for Nations. Now, anyone out there that's a heavy metal fan will know who Music for Nations are. They were the label that put out the first three Metallica records in Europe, the early Anthrax records in Europe, and a host of other bands. So, you know, it was quite a big deal, Music for Nations buying out Peaceville. And it came to a point after they'd done that they wanted to start meeting some of the bands that were on Peaceville. So it came to our turn where they wanted to meet us, but only two of us ended up going, and the only reason why I was one of the people that ended up going is the label was based in London, and my dad lived in London, so I could get us somewhere to stay, because Music for Nations were too tight to pay for a hotel for the whole band. So that's why only two of us ended up going. So anyway, I lived in London after that for many, many, many years. But at this point in 96, should I say, I didn't really know London at all. So, you know, getting on the train down to London, finding his way through the underground, the tube, to Latimer Road, which is where they were based. Now, obviously, it's quite a big deal going to, it was quite a big deal for us anyway, going to, you know, a label that you'd seen your favourite bands put out records on. So you go in there and it's all quite overwhelming and charming, and there's, you know, Metallica, Ride the Lightning and Master of Puppet gold discs on the wall, and Kill 'Em All platinum discs and stuff on the wall, you know. There's all these photos and records and stuff that you've grown up with everywhere. So, you know, it was quite a big deal for us. So we sat down, I believe it was with Martin Hooker, who's actually died recently, you know, but he was the guy that we were going to meet. Now, you know, he wanted to know about the band, the music, you know, the usual stuff that record labels want to know. And I got the impression straight away that he didn't particularly like me or the band, and that's another story. I'll go into that another time. But anyway, so this is we're meeting them with me and the bass player, and Hammy, who ran Peaceville, was there as well. So, you know, we were there for a good number of hours talking about, you know, what we're going to be doing in our next album and what gigs we were planning on doing, and you know, how was management going, and we found a manager and all that kind of thing. That's what we were talking about. So, you know, we spent a couple of hours there. The highlight of that actual afternoon was when they let us loose in their cupboards full of CDs, and we could take what CDs we wanted. So, you know, obviously we emptied the whole lot and took everything that we could physically carry for ourselves and other members of our band. So we had some free stuff, basically, which that was the best part of the afternoon at the label. Anyway, so after the meeting, we got driven and dropped off somewhere, and me, Danny and Hammy proceeded after this meeting to get absolutely leathered. We were, you know, we spent hours in this in pubs and going around Camden and you know, going to all these record shops and stuff. And it got, Hammy was staying in a hotel, I think in Notting Hill or somewhere like that. Maybe not Notting Hill, maybe it was Marble Arch or something. So it was somewhere around there, Ladbroke Grove, Lancaster Gate, somewhere like that. I can't remember where it was. It was somewhere not that far away from Marble Arch, Oxford Street. That it was quite central. So we staggered back to this hotel. We're all quite worse for wear. So we wanted to continue, but we didn't think that we looked in a good enough state to continue drinking in the hotel bar. So we went up to Hammy's room, and we proceeded to get absolutely annihilated in this room. So, you know, the drinks were flowing. The air had quite an exotic smell, shall we say. Back at the time when you could smoke in hotel rooms, you know, anyone who's younger out there won't know anything about that, but you used to be able to smoke in hotel rooms. So anyway, as the evening went on, we seriously were getting leathered, and we started getting hungry. So Hammy, being the good guy that he was, basically ordered us a load of food, and Peaceville paid for it. So, you know, we're having these burgers and whatever we were having, and by this time we're all quite silly, and we couldn't be bothered taking our plates back downstairs, so we just fucking launched them out of the window, and that ended up in a book. So I thought I'd share that with you. It's not something that I would recommend anyone to do. I mean, it was something that happened many, many, many years ago. And I just thought I'd tell you about it. So, you know, that's how that story ended up in that book. That was the afternoon that led up to that story. And the reason why the rock and roll behavior happened is because we were absolutely annihilated. And I don't remember Hammy arguing about those plates going out the window at the time either. So, you know, it's quite funny that ended up in a book, really. So now you know about that little story. So if you've enjoyed this video and you want to see more, then please like the channel and please subscribe to the channel. And, you know, I'm thanking everybody who sent me messages and stuff. It's been really nice to hear from people about the channel. And also as well, you know, I do want to get people involved in this channel. So if there's any things that you guys out there want me to talk about, feel free to send me a message, or if there's any stories that you remember that I'm involved in that you want me to talk about, if you want to refresh my memory on them, you know, hit me up. But for now, all of you out there, take care, stay rock and roll, and I'll be back soon with more videos for you. Cheers.